Let us perform the convolution between the two infinite duration sequences, x of n as a raised to n u of n, h of n impulse response as b raised to n u of n. From the given mathematical expression, it is clear that both the sequences are exponential sequences, where both of them, they are since getting multiplied with unit step function, their starting point is at n equal to 0. This is why the given system is a causal system. We start by writing the convolution sum formula, where in a basic formula it is minus to plus infinity, lower and upper limits are now changed to lower limit as 0, since both the sequences, they start at m equal to 0. To understand the upper limit, which is taken to be small n, let us sketch both x of m, h of m, and further the shifted form of the folded and shifted impulse sequence. X of m, which is an exponential function, is drawn at first place. Secondly, an impulse response h of m is plotted. Impulse response further is folded and obtained h of minus m. After folded operation, we find out and plot h of n minus m, which is a shifted form of h of minus m, where the first sample of h of n minus m will begin at n. For h of minus m, that was 0. To make sure whether we have correctly expressed this index, we can substitute n as 0 and check if it results into the same sequence which was there in h of minus m. Thus, h of n minus m will further start shifting over the fixed x of m. Now, when both of sequences will overlap, it is clear from this overlapped sequences that the lower limit is 0 and the upper limit will be decided, this instance n of h of n minus m, because beyond n, the sequence h of m minus n minus m is 0. Thus, the upper limit is fixed up to n. Followed by that, we substitute the values of x of m and h of n minus m, which is to be further simplified using the finite geometric sum series formula, where the value of a for the present example is a upon b, and thus we can obtain the convolution between an infinite duration sequences. On similar lines, you can solve x of n as 2 raised to n u of n and h of n as 1 by 3 raised to n u of n, as both of them are the exponential signals what are getting convolved. So again, by using the finite geometric sum series formula, we can obtain the output of the convolution for both these sequences. In this example, x of n is an exponential